Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Another one is given the gifts of faith. This gift does not stand on any word of God. You have that sure in you. That as I pray for this one, say something must happen. It's called the gift of faith. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is no scripture you are standing on. But there is a surety in your heart that this thing must happen. The gift of faith. The moment you are baptized with the Holy Ghost, the same day, he comes with the gifts. The same hour.
Wakati huu.
So the day you receive the Holy Ghost is the same day you receive the gifts of the Holy Ghost. But he uses you as the way you yield yourself. He uses you the more you yield yourself. The Holy Ghost. Everyone here can operate with those nine gifts. They are not entitled for preachers. It's a lie. I'll tell you with authority. They are not entitled for preachers. It is for everyone who is called a daughter and a son of God. Hello?
Amen.
You can operate with those gifts. If you desire to flow in them. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The other one is given the gift of prophecy. The gift of interpretation of tongues. And either diverse tongues. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But the Bible says, in the same book,
2
Corinthians chapter 12, talking about the gifts of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are you catching something?
Washika kitu.
Verse number 31. But covet earnestly for the best gifts, and yet I show you unto you a more excellent way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God is telling you,
Mungu yakueleza,
covet earnestly for the gift, best gift within those nine.
Zawadi nzuri, utafute ile nzuri kati ya zote tisa.
The one who say, I want to operate with this one.
Ile ambayo unasema unataka kufanya na hii.
Pursue it.
Itafute.
Because we are in the former rain.
Sababu tuko katika mvua zuri.
We are in the former rain.
Tuko katika mvua zuri.
That is number two characteristics of a former rain.
Hilo ni jambo la pili la mvua zuri.
Number three characteristics of a former rain.
Jambo la tatu la mvua zuri.
Is the ministry gifts of the Holy Ghost.
Ni kazi, ni zawadi ya kazi ya Roho Mtakatifu.
The fivefold ministry. What did I say? What did I say? Fivefold ministry. Fivefold ministry less in the former rain.
Iko katika mvua huu wa vuli.
Ephesians chapter 4.
Wa Efeso 4.
Verse 11 to 14.
Mstari wa 11 hadi 14.
And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying the body of Christ, till we all come to the unity of faith and to the knowledge of the Son of God and to a perfect man and to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Verse 14. That with from now on be no more children, be no more what? Hallelujah.
Amen.
These ministry gifts
zawadi za kazi
is to make believers
ni za kuwafanya waamini
to come from baby stage
watoke kutoka utoto
to become to maturity
ili wawe wamekomaa
come from baby stage
watoke kwa utoto
to enter to maturity
waingie katika ukomavu.
They are called fivefold ministry
and ni kazi aina tano.
They are given for believers
zapatiwa waamini
by the Holy Ghost
na Roho Mtakatifu.
Amen.
Amen.
So the former ring carries these three characteristics.
Wabeba hizi vitu vitatu.
where you are filled and baptized the Holy Ghost, evidence of speaking in tongues. Number two, operation of the gifts of the Holy Ghost, the nine gifts. And then very few people, they are called to ministry. Others are apostles, others are prophets, others are evangelists, pastors and teachers. This one is for the few people. The main purpose is to make believers, not to be tossed around by any wind of doctrine. They need to mature up. They need to grow, become to the same image of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And every believer
na kila mwamini
have an assignment
ana kazi
on this earth.
Na katika dunia.
Because he's saying there.
Kwa sababu yasema,
verse number 13.
Mstari wa 13.
Sorry, 12.
12.
For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry. Say, I have a work.
Nina kazi.
Say, I have a work to do.
Nina kazi ya kufanya.
Say, I have a work to do.
Nina kazi ya kufanya.
Here on earth.
Hapa duniani.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you think your work is to get married, get children.
Unafikiria kwa ni kuoleka ama kuoa upate watoto. Hapana.
That's not the primary work why you are here.
Hiyo sio sababu ya kuwa wewe uko hapa.
Hello.
Amen.
Your primary work.
Kazi yako ya kwanza.
To fulfill your destiny.
Ni kutimiza hatima yako.
To do what God has called you to do here on earth.
Kufanya kile ambacho Mungu amekuita kufanya.
That is your primary work.
Hiyo ndio kazi yako ya kwanza.
Hello.
Amen.
Jesus came to do his primary work.
Yesu alikuja kufanya kazi yake ya kimsingi.
Did he get married?
Haku. Alioa kweli?
Never.
Hapana.
Say, my primary work.
A kazi yangu ya msingi
is to do.
Ni kufanya.
One agenda.
A kazi moja.
When I find that one agenda.
Nikipata hiyo kazi.
You begin to shine.
Unaanza kung'aa.
You begin to shine.
Unaanza kung'aa.
You begin to shine.
Unaanza kung'aa.
And any other things are added to you.
Na mambo mengine yanaongezwa
kwako. As you have located the purpose of God in your life.
Unapojua mpango wa Mungu maishani mwako.
Many have called to become industries people.
Wengi wameitwa kuwa katika industries.
Because believers are sent.
Sababu waamini wametumwa.
Both to sinners and to believers.
Wote kwa waamini na wa usio
waamini. And the fivefold.
Na watu watano.
Is only sent for believers.
Wametumwa kwa waamini.
To make them to build up.
Ili wafanye kukua.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But the believers.
Lakini waamini.
Are sent.
Wametumwa.
Both.
Kwate.
To believers.
Kwa waamini.
And to non-believers.
Na wasioamini.
And that's why you have the mandate.
Ndiposa una kazi.
To tell people.
Kuwaeleza watu.
Come to church.
Njooni kanisani.
Come and see the word.
Njoo uone neno.
Come and hear it.
Njoo usikie.
You are sent to your work.
Unatumwa kwa
kazi. You are sent to your career.
Unatumwa kazini mwako.
You are sent to your business.
Unatumwa biasharani mwako.
That's where you are being sent.
And ndiposa
unatumwa. That's where your calling is.
Ndiposa kuitwa kwako.
Hello.
Amen.
There's somebody here, if I tell you come here and preach.
Kuna mtu akiwaita hapa waeleze
mungu. You sweat.
Utatoa jasho.
You feel like dying.
Utasikia ni kama utakufa.
Because you don't have grace to do that.
Sababu hauna rehema ya kufanya vile.
If you call somebody here to come and sing.
Ukimita mtu hapa aimbe.
You sing like a frog.
Ataimba kama chula.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because you are not called to eat.
Sababu haujaitiwa hiyo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every man, every woman.
Kila mwanamume ama mwanamke.
Has been called for a divine purpose.
Ameitwa kwa jambo fulani.
That purpose you are going to see it.
Hilo jambo utaenda kuliona.
That purpose you are going to fulfill it.
Hilo jambo utaenda kulitimiza.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Katika jina la Yesu Kristo.
So Christians are called to service the world.
Kwa hivyo waamini wameitwa kutumikia dunia.
Many of you are called to become doctors.
Wengi wameitwa kuwa madaktari.
Lawyers.
Au kuwa
others are being called to do one thing or the other.
Wengi wameitwa hili jambo ama lingine.
In business.
Katika biashara.
In any field.
Kwa kila eneo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because not all are called to become apostles.
Kwa sababu sio wengi wote wameitwa kuwa
not all are called to become evangelists.
Sio wengi wameitwa kuwa evangelists.
Not all are called to become prophets.
Sio wote wameitwa kuwa nabii.
Everyone has his own assignment.
Kila mmoja na kazi yake.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the fivefold ministry.
Kwa hivyo hizi zote tano.
We also called it.
Twaziita.
The priesthood office.
Zile za kipristi.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is a priesthood office.
Ni ofisi ya kipristi.
Given by the Holy Ghost.
Imepatiwa na Roho Mtakatifu.
So the Holy Ghost calls the man.
Kwa hivyo Roho Mtakatifu amfanya mtu.
In the book of Acts chapter 13.
Katika Matendo 13.
Verse number 1.
Mstari wa kwanza.
And verse 2.
Na mstari wa pili.
It says, now there were in the church that was at Antioch certain prophets and teachers, as Barnabas and Simon, that was called Niger, and Lucas. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What I want to is verse number 2, very important.
Mstari wa pili.
As they ministered unto the Lord and fasted, the Holy Spirit said, separate for me Barnabas and who? And so for the work of which I've called them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Holy Ghost gave the ministry gifts
aliwapatia zawadi za kazi
to Paul.
Ili kwa Paul.
It was called Saul. Also Barnabas.
Na pia Barnabas.
They were called into the office.
Walitwa ofisini.
Of the priesthood.
Ya kuwa makuhani.
Either it's prophet.
Kama nabii.
Or apostle.
Ama ni mhubiri.
That is the former rain.
Huo ndio mvua vuli.
Now let's see the characteristic of the latter rain.
Tuone mvua wa masika.
Joel chapter 2:23.
Yaani 2:23.
Be glad then, the children of Zion, rejoice the Lord your God, for he shall give you the former rain faithfully. Hallelujah. God has given the former rain faithfully. Since the time of Jesus until now.
Kutoka wakati wa Yesu hadi sasa.
The former rain.
Mvua wavuli.
Has been dominating.
Umekoki eneo.
The entire globe.
Katika kila eneo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In America and Africa.
Kule Marekani na hapa Afrika.
All over the world.
Kila mahali duniani.
The former rain is evident.
Mvua wavuli uko.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
With the great harvest of souls.
Ana kukiwa na kupata
signs and wonders.
Na ishara na miujiza.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And it caused to come for you the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. So what is the latter rain?
Mvua wa masika ni upi?
What is the latter rain?
Mvua wa masika ni upi?
Let's see in the book of Haggai.
Tuangalie kitabu cha Haggai.
Chapter number 2.
Mlango wa pili.
For thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once, it is a little while, I will shake the heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land, and I will shake all the nations, and the desires of the nations shall come. I'll fill this house with glory, thus says the Lord. The silver is mine, and the gold is mine, thus says the Lord of hosts. The glory of the latter house, say the latter house.
Mvua masika.
So the rain is designed for the latter house. The latter rain is designed for the latter house.
Mvua wa masika ni ya nyumba ya masika.
The glory of this latter house shall be greater than of the former. So the former rain.
Kwa hivyo mvua vuri.
Say the Lord of hosts. And in this place I will give peace, says the Lord of hosts. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is a rain of glory.
Ni mvua wa utukufu.
Is the rain of what? It is a rain that's going to shake the heavens.
Ni mvua ambayo utatingiza bingu.
It is the rain that's going to shake the world.
Ni mvua utakatingiza dunia.
Because of the mighty works.
Sababu ya kazi kubwa.
People shall wonder.
Watu watashangaa.
Ah.
Ah.
Is it thing possible?
Ni jambo lawezekana.
Ah. Say the former rain.
Mvua masika.
Brings glory.
Waleta utukufu.
To your life.
Kwa maisha yako.
So that you may become the saviors of the world.
Ili uwe mkombozi wa dunia.
The purpose of the former rain.
Kazi ya mvua vuli.
Is to redeem men.
Ni kukomboa watu.
But the purpose of the latter rain.
Lakini kazi ya mvua masika.
Is to make the sons of God to manifest.
Ni kufanya wana wa Mungu wa
as a true sons of God.
Wakae kama wana wa Mungu.
As they go out to the world.
Wanapoenda kule duniani.
The world sees them as saviors.
Dunia inaona kama wakombozi.
Hello.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The latter rain.
Mvua wa vuli.
Is designed.
Umewekwa.
To build.
Ili ujenge.
The waste cities.
Ile miji imepotea.
It is ordained.
Imewekwa.
To build cities.
Ili kuunda miji.
On the earth.
Duniani.
The latter rain.
Mvua.
Why?
Mbona?
Because the hour has come.
Sababu wakati umefika.
People to see the glory of God.
Watu waone utukufu wa Mungu.
In reality.
Kwa macho yao.
The glory we are looking for this year will be provoked by the latter rain.
Tutauona kwa mvua wa masika.
The latter rain.
Mvua wa masika.
Hello.
Amen.
I'm going slowly because I don't want you to miss anything.
Yuenda pale pale ili usikose kushika chochote.
The latter rain.
Mvua wa masika.
Is a rain of restoration.
Ni mvua wa urejesho.
The latter rain.
Mvua masika.
Is a rain of dominion.
Ni mvua wa mamlaka.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The waste places shall be built again.
Zile ambazo zimepotea.
Restoration.
Hiyo ni urejesho.
The latter rain.
Mvua masika.
Is for the latter house.
Ni ya nyumba ya masika.
For the children of God.
Ili watoto wa Mungu.
To reflect the glory of God.
Watoe utukufu wa Mungu.
Amen.
Amen.
Obadiah verse is only one chapter.
Obadiah ambayo ina mlango mmoja tu.
Obadiah. It is the neighbor of Amos and Jonah.
Ni jirani ya Amosi na Yona.
If you reach to Amos, then you find Obadiah there. And then is if you are in Jonah, go back.
Kama uko Yona, rudi nyuma.
Verse number 21.
Mstari 21.
It says,
yasema,
and saviors shall come out from Mount Zion. From where?
Kutoka mlima Sayuni.
Saviors.
Wakombozi.
Saviors.
Wakombozi.
Can you see S? That means there are many. There are what?
Ni wengi.
Saviors.
Waokoaji.
We have one savior.
Tuna mkombozi mmoja.
Jesus Christ.
Yesu Kristo.
But here the Bible says.
Na hapa Biblia yasema.
Saviors.
Wakombozi.
Shall come.
Watatoka.
From Mount Zion.
Mlima Sayuni.
Mount Zion represents church.
Mlima Sayuni ni kanisa.
To judge the mountains of Israel. And the kingdom shall be the Lord's. Hallelujah.
Amen.
These people,
how watu,
they will emerge as saviors.
Wataenda kama wakombozi.
With the rattling.
Na mvua ya masika.
To expand the territory of God.
Ili wainue eneo la Mungu.
Wherever they appear.
Mahali ambapo waendapo.
Hello.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Those testimonies you had here that day. She went anointed.
Shuhuda ambazo nasikia kwamba alienda na katifu upaku.
Those are saviors on the ground.
Hao ni wakombozi hapa.
Those are what? Saviors on the streets.
Ni wakombozi mjini.
Saviors on the workplace.
Wakombozi kazini.
Saviors in their companies.
Wakombozi kampuni.
Say God will send me as a savior.
Mungu atanituma kama mkombozi.
To that company.
Katika hiyo kampuni.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are entering a company and the company is dying.
Kama unaingia katika kampuni na yafa.
You are not a savior.
Wewe si mkombozi.
You have a problem.
Una shida.
You don't have the latter rain.
Hauna mvua masika.
Hello.
Amen.
Another one enters the same company.
Mwingine yoingia hiyo kampuni.
Like Joseph.
Kama Yusufu.
And being things begin to go.
Vitu zikaanza kusonga.
Expanding.
Zikaanza kuenea.
Forward.
Zikisonga mbele.
Those are saviors.
Hao ni wakombozi.
Say saviors.
Wakombozi.
Say God is sending me as a savior.
Mungu ananituma kama mkombozi.
Hello.
Amen.
Say the latter rain.
Mvua masika.
Is for the saviors.
Ni wa wakombozi.
Romans chapter 8.
Warumi 8.
Verse number 19.
Mstari wa 19.
Romans chapter 8.
Warumi 8.
Verse number 19.
Mstari wa 19.
It says.
Yasema hivi.
For the earnest expectation of the Christians waits for the manifestation of the sons of God. What are they waiting? Manifestation of the sons of God.
Kujitokeza kwa wana wa Mungu.
Sons and the daughters of God.
Waume na waume.
The world is waiting for you.
Dunia ya kugoza.
To manifest as saviors.
Ili ukue kama mkombozi.
As saviors.
Kama mkombozi.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So what contains in this latter rain?
Nini ambacho kiko katika huu mvua masika?
Let us go to the book of Revelation.
Tuangalie katika Ufunuo.
Chapter number 3.
Mlango wa 3.
Because this one is only located in that book now.
Sababu hii iko katika hicho kitabu tu.
Revelation chapter 3.
Ufunuo 3.
Verse number 1.
Mstari ni wa kwanza.
And to the angel of the church in Sardis, write. These things says he that has the seven spirits of God. Say seven spirits.
Loho saba.
Shout seven spirits.
Loho saba.
of what?
Za Mungu.
And seven stars. And what? Who is having the seven spirits of God? Say Jesus.
Yes, ana roho saba za Mungu.
He says, he that has the seven spirits of God.
Yule ambaye ana roho saba za Mungu.
Jesus is the one who possesses.
Yesu ndiye anazo.
The seven spirits of God.
Roho saba za Mungu.
The seven spirits of God.
Roho saba za Mungu.
For what purpose?
Kwa kazi gani?
For saints to become stars. To become what?
Ili wawe nyota.
Say I'll become a star.
Niwe nyota.
Say I'll become a star.
Nitakuwa nyota.
But the reason of the seven spirits of God.
Ya roho saba za Mungu.
That's what we call the latter rain.
Hiyo ndio mvua masika.
The latter rain.
Mvua masika.
Is about the seven spirits of God.
Uko katika roho saba za Mungu.
Paul never mentioned it.
Paulo hakunena.
Even Peter never mentioned it.
Hata Petro hakuyanena.
But in the book of Revelation.
Lakini katika Ufunuo.
It has been revealed.
Imepatikana.
The latter house.
Katika nyumba ya masika.
Shall be glorified.
Itainuliwa.
By the operations.
Na kazi.
And the activities.
Na mambo.
Of the seven. Seven spirits.
Ya roho saba za Mungu.
How many spirits? Say seven spirits.
Roho saba.
Are reserved for the end times. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When the seven spirits are in operation.
Roho saba wakati ziko kazini.
You are in full dominion.
Wewe una mamlaka zaidi.
You are in full dominion.
Uko na mamlaka.
Wow. Let us go to the Revelation chapter 4.
Ufunuo 4.
Verse number 5.
Mstari wa 5.
He says, and out of the throne heads crown of gold. Sorry. Out of the throne proceed lightnings and thunders and voices. And there are seven lamps of fire burning before the throne, which are the seven spirits of God. Which are what? Shall the seven spirits of God. So there is a lampstand.
Kwa hivyo kuna.
That last time is in the throne of God.
Kuna taa ambayo iko katika enzi ya Mungu.
It have seven arms.
Ina mikono saba.
And with the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Na ina moto wa Roho Mtakatifu.
And he says.
Na yasema.
Those are the seven spirits of God.
Hizo ndizo roho saba za Mungu.
Say seven spirits of God.
Roho saba za Mungu.
So for saints to be in enthronement.
Ili waamini wawe katika kile
kile. They need to operate with the seven spirits of God.
Wanafaa kufanya na zile roho saba za Mungu.
How many spirits? How many? How many? Revelation chapter 5.
Ufunuo 5.
Verse number 6.
Mstari wa 6.
And behold, and lo, in the midst of the throne, and of the four living creatures, and the midst of elders, stood the lamb, as though it has been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God, sent forth into all the earth. Where have they been sent for?
Katika dunia yote.
Say they are sent in this earth.
Ametumwa duniani.
Say they are locating me.
Wananielekea mimi.
Say these seven spirits.
Hizi roho saba.
They are locating me finally.
Zinanipata mwishowe.
Hello.
Amen.
Jesus.
Yesu.
The Son of the Most High God.
Mwana wa Mungu.
Is the one who possesses.
Ndiye ambaye anaye.
The seven spirits of God.
Roho saba za Mungu.
For your glorification.
Ili kwa utukufu wako.
For your dominion.
Ili kwa mamlaka yako.
For you to become the savior.
Ili wewe uwe mkombozi.
For Jesus to become the savior of the world.
Ili Yesu awe mkombozi wa dunia.
These seven spirits.
Hizi roho saba.
Rested upon him.
Zilimwingia yeye.
In the book of Isaiah.
Katika Isaya.
Chapter number 11.
Mlango wa 11.
We want to see what are these seven spirits.
Tunataka kuona hizi roho saba ni zipi.
Isaiah 11.
Isaya 11.
Verse 1 and 2.
Mstari wa kwanza na mbili.
And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch that shall grow out of his roots. So who is going to grow out of the stem of Jesse? Say Jesus Christ.
Yesu Kristo.
So Jesus Christ is that branch.
Yesu Kristo ndiye ule mti.
Who came from the stem of Jesse.
Amba alitoka kutoka kwa Yesu.
From Jesse we have David.
Kutoka Yesu tuna Daudi.
You go all the down.
Tunaenda kule chini.
According to the book of Matthew.
Kulingana na kitabu cha Mathayo.
The genealogy of Jesus.
Kuhusu mambo
ya Jesus was born.
Mpaka Yesu akazaliwa.
And he said verse number 2.
Mstari wa pili.
And the spirit of the Lord. Say one.
Moja.
Say one. Say one. The Spirit of the Lord.